สวัสดีเด็กๆทุกคนนะครับ Good afternoon right นะ So have you been well Yes you have นะครับมา Today let's talk about what is going to be on the next chapter that is chapter 6นะครับ week 6 So this week 6 we are going to talk about biology perspective remember from last week we also talk about biology but in term ofchemical substance, right? For example, serotonin. Remember, right? When we are having some anxiety, we have serotonin or we have another chemical substance released from our, you know, nervous system. We call it dopamine, right? That is the thing that we studied last week, before the COVID. So let's talk about COVID for a second. I hope you guys be safeAnd don't forget to just wash your hand, wear glove, and protect yourself at all time. Okay? Hopefully we can pass this moment together, you and me. Let's talk about our study material this week. So this is called biology. Biology perspective. Last week we talked about nervous system. This week also biology, but different perspective, different angles.We call it hormone, that one, hormone. So let me just zoom in, okay? Zoom in this. So together, this one, for body, right? We have nervous system. This is from last week. And this week, we're gonna study about hormones. So what are the hormones that affect our personalities, okay? So you guys ready?So I hope you are ready now. If we take, I will just ask like 10 or 20 or even the maximum is 30 minutes of your time. Because if I make a longer video, you guys would fall asleep, right? I know that. So just be awake, and Kelvin and everyone, Nuprem. So I hope you enjoy this video, okay? Just having some fun together. For the biology, for the biology perspective or biology personality, first we have to talk about this one, hormone. For the hormones, normally we have two types of hormone that we are going to consider in this chapter. The first one is the hormone for male, and the second one.Is the hormone for female, okay? So we have one for male, the other one is for female. Let's talk about the male hormone first and how it's gonna affect our personality. For the male hormone, we have, we have the name for it. And the name is this one, okay? The name for the male hormone is this one. You can take a look here, This one, it's called testosterone, and another one we call androgen. So these, they are two names, but in fact, the two names, even though they are the two names, but still we can use it interchangeably, okay? We just like it, sometimes we call it testosterone or sometimes we call it androgen, but anyway, they are pretty much the same thing because testosterone is just a part of androgen. So both are for male, the alpha male had this, okay? So what if a girl want to be a boy? If a girl want to be a boy, then a girl have to inject herself with this hormone. Then a girl might become a tomboy, okay? All right, so this is the thing.So our personality affect by this hormone as well. So if you are tomboy or tomgirl, you need to do something with this hormone we call androgen or testosterone, okay? Next, for the girl, we have this, okay? This called hormone for the girl, we call it estrogen. So estrogen, okay, they just control the behavior of the girl.All right, okay, so if you are the girl, this is your hormone นะ so what if a boy นะ like a boy want to be a girl what happened if a boy wants to be a girl then he has to intake some of this estrogen okay because actually both boys and girl has both hormones okay so actually in one cell like for example me also have androgen and estrogen but we have little bit okay just very tiny of you know the girl hormone that's why I become a man okay and both are just they just look right here nah they just produce nah like both hormone nah the male hormone we call androgen and the female hormone we call estrogen both are produced by adrenal gland okay adrenal gland say this is a tom nah tom something with this gland thing okay inside the kidney okay tom tai tai or something like that but mok tai so you can just search for it nah adrenal gland so that gland will produce this hormone okay but like for some example nah this special hormone like testosterone also produced by our testicle if you are a male nah if you are a man has to got a testicle right and that produce this hormone as well okay so now what are these two hormones affect our perspective our personality well just take a look at this nah so if you are a male we call it testosterone right you are happen to have some aggressive mean like you want to like fighting someone okay if you want to fight someone then your testosterone is very high nah. See that is very special meaning for the boy so that's why the boy tend to have more aggressive than the girl because of the hormone okay next these are some example okay if a mother okay she's you know pregnant right when she pregnant she might intake some hormone for example she might intake some androgen okay or some testosterone by mistake or just accidentally have a bit of you know androgen or the testosterone inside her body then when she deliver suppose she has a baby girl that baby girl might have some testosterone nah to her so that's why that baby girl might grow up and in the near future she might develop some male like you know like become a like from a girl she become a tomboy because by accident yeah, because of her mother just being you know contaminated or just being maybe overdosed with the testosterone okay so that is what you know the science have tried to prove that hey you are tomboy or tomgirl maybe it is because of your mama okay that is another thing that you should consider okay so next if you are for example if you are study about the hormone thing okay so the dominant the hormone for the male or we call testosterone right testosterone yeah okay they are just want to be a dominant mean they just want to be the leader they would just want to you know be the controller okay so that's more aggressive want to control people okay more you know they are more confident now if okay you are another one okay this is for another hormone we call antisocial that also another effect of the testosterone okay this called antisocial or it can be impulsive I already explained to you impulse mean you just act nah by reflection no need to think about it okay impulse mean like you just when something happen you just react by your reflex only okay so that is the thing nah okay so this is the study about the hormone for this one, testosterone, okay? Another thing is called impulsivity. This is also another, just the same thing as this one, impulsive, okay? Impulsivity means you just want something very extreme. For example, you just want to go out and do the roller coaster, or you just want to be in a haunted house or something. Just try to find something that is, you know, give your heart pumped all the time, like pumping, pam, pam, pam. And that's the thing. That's impulsivity. Okay? So next. When we talk about stress, stress. Well, both men, okay, and women, they got stress. So how do we deal with the stress? Each hormone, like male hormone, okay, male hormone, testosterone, and female hormone, estrogen. So these two hormones have their, you know, way of dealing with stress or anxiety, okay? So how do we differentiate them? How do we separate them? So very easy. So for men, we have the word fight, okay? Fight and flight, meaning when there are some, you know, some threat, some stress going on, they tend to fight, you know, boxing, banging, kicking all the time. And then, you know, and after that, they just leave. Okay, so they fight first. But for the girl, okay, different. For the girl, for the man, they fight first. For the girl, they tend to do this tending, okay? Tending. And then befriend and tending. Meaning, if there is a stress going on, they tend to have someone to talk to, and they just want to befriend. They just, you know, consulting with someone, not fighting. They're just talking. So this is the way the hormone will tell, you know, each, you know, side, like the man side do this, and the girl side also do that. So this is the different thing, okay? You should consider this in your, you know, lecture as well, okay? All right, now, so this is the thing that the big part of this, you know, this chapter. Next, what are the tools, okay? The tools, what are the tools that we measure, or what are the tools that can measure our nervous system, or to measure our, you know, stress signal? So how do we measure that? Okay, we have three, this so far, we have three measurements or three tools to measure our, you know, brain activity, our nervous system, or our hormone thing, okay? So first we have EGG. So for the EGG, you can study. EGG stands for electro, okay? Encephalogram, okay? So this thing, the egg, I call it egg. So what are the eggs, or what is the egg? Egg is just to measure your brain wave. So it's just like another gadget to put into your head, and some wires coming out to measure your brain wave, man, and then check whether your brain wave is good or not and how to deal with it. So just read more information, okay? But just remember that we have egg, okay? Next tool, what is the next tool? We have PET, right? PET, yeah, this one, PET. PET, okay? PET, in short, we just PET, okay, PET. So this PET stand for what? The PET stand for, positron, okay? Positron emission, tomography, okay? Tomography is just a term for graphic or something, So this PET, they use the radioactive, okay? They use the radioactive, just like a gamma radioactive, to measure, okay, the chemical substance, or to measure the picture inside your brain, okay? And then they just find out what's happening, if you have some cancer or if you have something going on in your body that is not right, then they will detect those, you know, bad area, and the doctor can examine, the doctor can, you know, do things after they have checked with this PET. So we have second two already. The first two is EEG, right? EEG, A, this one, A. The second two is PET, PET. And the last one that we have, the tools to check our biology, okay? That is the, this one, MRI, okay? MRI. MRI, in short, we just call it magnetic, okay? Magnetic resonance imaging. So this MRI is very common. I think you have known it, right? So the MRI, one of the special thing about MRI is that they can check all parts of our body from head to toe. So if there's something wrong going on, because MRI use the radioactive, okay, so sorry, use the radio, okay, like this, use the electromagnetic, okay, that is some kind of waveform, electromagnetic, okay, use a magnet and the radio, plus together we call radiomagnetic, okay. So this thing is to check what? To check your body, you know, like the fluid, like the chemical fluid, okay, like for example the dopamine level, okay, or the serotonin level, or even the hormone level. They can check everything by using this three tools, okay. Once again, what are they? First, EGGA. Second, okay, it's called PET, PET, and the third one is MRI. All right, okay, now we come to the last part of this thing already, okay? Once again, I will just summarize this chapter for you, okay? One more time. Now, for the bio perspective, we separate into two types. The first one is nervous system, which we already learned last week, remember? Now, we learned about the BAS, BAS, remember BAS, right? Behavioral approach, okay? The system, and BIS is also behavioral. I is like the inhibited, right? And S is system. So that is what we studied last week. But now, another perspective we call biology, but this time we're gonna study in terms of hormones. So the basic hormone for our human beings, there are two types. The first one is the male hormone we call androgen or testosterone. The second one, female hormone, we call estrogen or egg, okay? We have egg, no? So that two type of hormone plays different role in our personality. For example, if you are aggressive, that means you have more of testosterone, okay? Or the female, or the male hormone. So, but if you are like talking, being with someone, just love to be with someone else, friends, or just like to consult first rather than fighting, that is you have a, you know, female hormone or estrogen, okay? Both hormones, they are produced by the adrenal gland, okay? That's a thing that you should understand it, all right? So these are the chapter, okay? The chapter week number, the chapter about biology, right? Biology perspective. So I hope you enjoy this clip video, okay? And don't forget, try to learn about this thing, okay? Learn about this thing and make note of it, because it will be in your final exam, okay? All right? No? So please enjoy and just have a wonderful afternoon, okay? Bye-bye. Ah, so what day, Cup? I hope to see you again next week, okay? Don't be lazy. And again, take care of yourself all the time, okay? Be safe, be strong, and be together. Okay, enjoy.